Hello students.
In previous video, we have discussed the beginning part of the lesson Indigo. Today we will continue that part. Just for the recap, I will take some important things from the beginning. So here in the beginning, author mentioned about the some important things in that. I visited Gandhi in 1942, and then reference of the year, I decided to urge the departure of the British. It was in 1970. So here on the part of Gandhiji, it is said that Gandhiji insisted Britishers to go back. Same here about the Indian National Congress Party's annual convention, here it is mentioned. Then author introduced Rajkumar Shukla. He was the recent poor person, and he was insisting Gandhiji to visit Champaran. Then that Rajkumar Shukla, he followed him. He was determined. Here Rajkumar Shukla was illiterate, but he was determined. So this here fact, it is important, and we have discussed that how Rajkumar Shukla followed Gandhiji. He went to the ashram also, and literally finally he said that you fix the date, then only he will go. So like this here, he was very determined, impressed by the sharecropper's tenacity. Means he was tenacity, means very determined. And Gandhiji was impressed with that Rajkumar Shukla's determination, firmness. And story, Gandhi said, I have to be in Calcutta on such and such a day. Come and meet me and take me from there. So here, Calcutta, that place it is mentioned, and Gandhiji had given the word appointment to him that okay, surely I will come there and you take me from that place. Then months passed. Shukla was sitting on his haunches at the appointed spot in Calcutta when Gandhiji arrived. When he was waiting there, that Gandhiji will come and he will take. So this type of nature, it is important that when someone is assigning you the work, someone will give you some appointments, then you have to be there on that particular time, and you should have that politeness, you should have that eagerness, and you should be very punctual. And here we can understand that he was the illiterate, but determined, all important. He was punctual, he was waiting there, that courtesy, respect, all that things we can observe in the Rajkumar Shukla's nature. Then next, what is the thing we can understand here? Months passed. Shukla was sitting on his haunches at the appointed spot in Calcutta when Gandhi arrived. He waited it till Gandhi was free. So he was waiting there, and others also, they would come there to meet him, because Gandhiji was a famous personality, and he was waited there as a peasant. He was just observing. He was waiting there. And then the two of them boarded a train for the city of Patna in Bihar. So here, boarded the train, they started journey to the train. And then there, Shukla led him to the house of a lawyer named Rajendra Prasad. So here, everybody, you can understand who was the Rajendra Prasad in the history. He was a well-known personality, and here it is also mentioned that Rajendra Prasad will later become president of the Congress Party of personality, Rajendra Prasad personality. And here it is, one more new leader name is mentioned. Then what happened next? Rajendra Prasad was out of town, he was not there. But the servants knew Shukla as a poor yeoman who persisted their master to help the indigo share crops. So here, Rajendra Prasad, their servants were there, and servants recognized the poor peasant, Rajkumar Shukla. Here yeoman means a man holding or cultivating a small land in his state. That poor farmer like that, we can hear that meaning. Poor yeoman who persisted, means persistently or consistently, frequently, he used to go there, request or rough that Rajkumar here, Shukla, he used to do so many things. And because of his frequent visits to the Rajendra Prasad also, the servants recognized him. And then, so they let him stay on the grounds with his companion, Gandhi. So, on that ground, here, servants don't know about Mahatma Gandhi. They didn't recognize Mahatma Gandhi. So, here, on ground only, along with Rajkumar Shukla, Gandhiji was also there as a companion, whom they took to be another peasant. And because of the appearance, Gandhiji's appearance was not like the lawyer or something. His attitude, his all things, it was like a common man. He used to behave everywhere like a common man. So his costume, everything, it was like a common, even though he was the barrister. So here we can understand that how, suppose you will have such type of appearance, then the servants will also behave with such type of way. So here we can understand this important factor. Then whom they took be another patient, but Gandhi was not permitted to draw water from well, lest some drops from his bucket pollute the entire source of that water, means untouchability. It was more a problematic thing in those days that poor peasants or those who are from the backward classes, they used to think about such type of things, that there was a prohibition on the part of those who are on the upper caste. Like that system, here Gandhiji now we are experiencing, even though he was not untouchable, because of he was the companion with that peasant, and the peasant might be getting such type of treatment like untouchability from those who are educated or high class of people or upper class. So this is the case here Gandhiji experienced now. So from the well, like some drops from his bucket pollute the entire source. How did they know that he was not untouchable? So how they would understand that he was not, means the Gandhiji was not untouchable. So your question it is asked, why do you think the servants thought Gandhi to be another peasant? So the reason is here, because of his appearance, because of his common appearance like peasant, they didn't recognize the Gandhiji, very famous personality, and they have given the treatment like untouchable to that very well-known personality, which is Mahatma Gandhi. Now the next journey, again here it is described. Gandhi decided to go first to Muzaffarpur, which was en route to Champaran. En route is on the way to Champaran. To obtain more complete information about conditions than Shukla was capable of imparting. So here, suppose someone will give you small information, on that basis you cannot blame any person, or you will not win the dialogues or arguments with landlords. Suppose you will not have clear and detailed information about the situation. So, to obtain or to know, to gain more information about the situation and the problems of peasants, here Gandhiji decided to go ahead to obtain more complete information about conditions than Shukla was capable to impart, to gain, to sustain that information. He accordingly sent a telegram to Professor J.B. Kriflani. So here his contacts were very strong, and here Gandhiji sent telegram to Professor J.B. Kriflani of the Arts College in Muzaffarpur, whom he had seen at Tagore Shantiniketan School. So here Rabindranath Tagore Shantiniketan School's reference it is given, and they might have earlier communication like this. Here it is mentioned. So here that communication things, here we can understand. Suppose you are the good leader, you will have that dialogue with different people in different areas, and that dialogue will work. Then the train arrived at midnight. The train arrived at midnight here, 15th April 1970, reference it is given. Kriflani was waiting at the station with a large body of students, and he was the professor, and the students like you, they were also in the youth, and suppose any great personality would come here, then what they will do, they will also be there, because youth can change most of the things. So here students were also there, large body of students. Gandhi stayed there for 2 days in the home of Professor Malkani, a teacher in a government school. So here government teacher, government school, then government, all rules, regulations, that person, it is mandatory to follow. And here it was an extraordinary thing in those days. Why? To give center to the person who is in such, means here further it is mentioned, for a government professor to harbor a man like me. Here infer the meaning, in that it is given, a harbor a man like me means to give center to an advocate of whom. So who was that person? Here it is mentioned, to harbor a man like me in the smaller localities, the Indians were afraid to show sympathy for advocates of home rule. Here a home rule mission, home rule movement, everybody you can understand, you have already studied in the history. So here he was the advocate of that home rule, and no one will give him shelter, because government officers, police, they will come and they will arrest that person, or they may give the punishment, penalty. So it was not ordinary task, it was the extraordinary task to give him permission to stay there. So here this explained, for a government officer to harbor a man like me in smaller localities, the Indians were afraid to show sympathy for advocates of home rule. Then further here it is proceed, in that further things what is here mentioned. The news of Gandhi's advert of the nature of his mission spread quickly through Muzaffarpur and to Champaran. So here, now Gandhiji was there, he was famous, and the news of Gandhi's advent means the arrival of that notable famous personality was spread in that area. And here, and the nature of his mission spread quickly through Muzaffarpur. And what was his mission? the mission to help the sharecroppers in that Champaran, and it was spread in all that area, the Muzaffarpur and to Champaran. The sharecroppers from Champaran began arriving on food. They were illiterate and poor also, so most of them they come by foot, and some by conveyance or using some vehicles or means of the transport to see their champion. And for them, here Gandhiji was the champion. They were thinking that Gandhiji is the champion because he would help them. And in that case, if the mob or the mass is accepting you as a leader, so their acceptance, because they are observing your intention. Suppose you have that selfless intention, then the mass will follow you, the people will follow you, and it is what we have observed in this also phase. So Muzaffarpur lawyers called on Gandhi to brief him. They frequently represented peasant groups in court. They told him about their cases and reported on the side of their fee. So here we can understand one more again thing. Legally, lawyers, they are the major supporters. Here, Muzaffarpur, that area, that lawyers, they have given, means when they had a meeting with Mahatma Gandhi, they had given all details about that, what type of cases is there, and about the fees, whatever fees they are taking from the peasant, because they were the poor peasant, and the nature of the fee, everything here Gandhiji discussed. Means, what was the intention of Gandhiji? To take information from peasant, to take information from lawyers, complete information. He was willing to take or willing to obtain complete information, and when that complete draft will be ready, then he will proceed to help, or he will communicate, he will represent the peasants, and he would represent the sharecroppers, and then he would go ahead, or he would proceed to the landlords. So like that it would be their plan. So Gandhi ceded the lawyers for collecting the fee from the sharecroppers. Here ceded means he was angry at that time. So he scolded the lawyers that you are educated, but they are the poor peasant and they have problem of their survival. And why you are taking more fees from them to give justice? Here lawyers, they are helping the poor people to give justice with the help of the court. But here it is observed that they were taking more fees from the sharecroppers. So here Gandhiji scolded them. He said, I have come to the conclusion that we should stop going to law courts. So what is the conclusion? We should stop going to the law courts, because if here we are taking more fees, then surely peasants will not come. They will not have access towards that. And what they will do? They will feel that understanding of the things here, it is not good. And no one is understanding their feelings. No one is understanding their actual problem. And everyone they are extorting from them. Everyone they are demanding money from them. So if they are having a problem, money if they will not give, then lawyers will not entertain them. So such type of things here. I have come to the conclusion that we should stop going to law courts. Taking such cases to the courts does little good. Where the peasants are so crushed and fears become, law courts are useless. The real relief for them is to be free from fear. So there is fear in their mind about the system. There is fear in their mind about the bureaucrats. There is fear in their mind about the court. or there is fear in their mind about the landlords. So when they will free from that fear, then only it will happen that something good. When they will have confidence to fight, then only we can observe, then only we can understand that everything can be done in positive way. So here, one more important thing here it is mentioned, and that is the last line. The real relief for them is to be free from fear. When they will be free from the fear, means whenever, suppose you have fear, you will not raise your voice. You will not go against the landlord system. So here it is very important thing, it is explained. Most of the arable land in the Champaran district was divided into large estates owned by Englishmen and one by Indian tenants. So here Indian tenants, they used to work in that farm. The chief commercial crop was indigo. So here the title is given indigo, and this indigo was the chief commercial crop. And the landlords compelled, so here all tenants, so it was compulsory for them what they have to do. The landlords compelled all tenants to plant 3/20 or the 15% of their holding with indigo and surrender the entire indigo harvest as rent. So here this was the deal. And as a poor peasant, they used to accept whatever their landlords they will tell, and it was the acceptance, and they used to surrender the entire indigo harvest as rent, and only here 15% of their holding with indigo, and the entire things they will give it to the landlords. This was done by long-term contract. And this was done with a long-term contract, and there was a contract, legal contract. So through that, this activity was fixed. Presently, now situation changed. And what happened? The landlords learned that Germany had developed synthetic indigo. New inventions, new things whenever new things come up. Nowadays also you can observe that due to the CPU or so many things, modern equipments, we don't want laborers now. Very few laborers required for construction work or for the road or highways also nowadays you can observe. So most of the things, machineries, they are going. So here, those who are illiterate, what they will do? They will not have such type of, they are not skilled workers. So most of the time they are being humiliated. Here the Germany had developed synthetic indigo. They thereupon obtain agreement from the sharecroppers to pay them compensation for being released from 15% agreement. So now here landlords, they want compensation, and they are now here started cheating the peasants, and peasants would not be ready for that. But here, how is the cheating here, we can understand. Thereupon obtain agreement from the sharecroppers to pay in compensation for being released from the 15% sharecropping agreement was exam to the peasants, and many signed willingly. They don't know what is there in that agreement, what is there in that contract. So they signed willingly. Those who registered engaged lawyers. So some they might have understood that this is the income or the wrong plan, or it is the harassment on the part of landlord. So here those who registered engaged lawyers, the landlords hired thugs. So here gangsters like that people they used to hire, and whoever will come, any poor person will come to rebel or ask something about that, they might be using the formula to beat that person or to threaten that person. Then that poor person may not come again to ask the question. So like this here, meanwhile, the information about synthetic indigo reached the illiterate pigeons who had signed, and they wanted their money back. And now, again here, now they want their money back. So it was the cheating that they will not get the money from whom? Landlords. And now that money would be pending with the landlord. Landlords will not give them, because now the new agreement they have done. Now they have willingly signed. They don't know, because of the illiteracy, that what is in that agreement. And now this is the legal process. And through that legal process, now here, Mahatma Gandhi, he was barrister, he could understand better that how to fight legally with such type of problems. But without proofs in courts, we cannot go ahead. So here, at this point, Gandhi arrived in Champaran. Now the further journey, further course of the here lesson, the story we can understand. Now it is the main thing, how is the plot development? In this plot development, now the main area, the main focus area is here Champaran. He began by trying to get the facts. First, he visited the secretary of British Landlords Association. And now he was the barrister. He will not have any fear about English landlords or their secretary or their association. So directly what happened? First, he visited the secretary of the British Landlord Association. The secretary told him that they could give no information to an outsider. Gandhi answered that he was no outsider. So here, the secretary of that landlord association, he entertained here Mahatma Gandhi. And what was the fact here we can understand? The barrister-like person, if they are not providing any information, how they will provide the information to the poor peasant or the sharecroppers? And here, what was the clause? He mentioned that you are outsider, you are not from this area. So, we are not liable for here such type of to give any information to the outsider. If you are from this area, we may provide you information, but you are outsider. So, here Gandhiji here specifically mentioned, and Gandhi answered that I was no outsider, I am not outsider, I am from the same country, and I have that right to ask about the information. Then here, next step. So step by step here, Gandhiji proceed to the main mission, main goal. And now what happened? Next, Gandhi called on a British official commissioner of the Tirhut division, in which the Champaran district lay. So here, next Gandhi called, right? Now here, again, one important thing, it is here mentioned about the British Landlord Association and that secretary, their dialogue, their meeting. Then next, again official here, a British official commissioner in the Tirhut division, in which the Champaran district lay. So here, Gandhiji started taking information from official sources, and he started discussing about the official sources from that district, and especially post is given here, commissioner post. The commissioner, Gandhi reports, proceeded to bullying me and advised me forthwith to leave Tirhut. So here, the commissioner said that you leave Tirhut division, don't stay here, don't wait here. Like that here, the order it is given from the commissioner. So now, next what happened? Gandhi didn't leave. So Gandhiji, he was a barrister. He will not have any kind of fear about the commissioner or a waiver would be there. He would give answer in the court, or he can set the dialogues or argument in the court against such type of injustice. So here, Gandhi did not leave. Instead, he proceeded to Motihari. So instead of that, he proceeded to that Motihari village. And why he proceeded there? That Motihari, the capital of Champaran, several lawyers accompanied him. Now here, he was not alone. He was with the lawyers were also there, or the pigeons would be also with him. So here, several lawyers accompanied him at the railway station. A vast multitude greeted Gandhi. And here Gandhiji got that all information. So many greeted also Gandhiji. And here he went to a house and using it as a headquarter, continued his investigation. And he continued his investigation, and now further he got one news about that. What is that news? A report came in that a peasant had been maltreated in nearby village, maltreated or harassed in the nearby village. And now the current issue is important. Whenever you are raising any issue, the current issue is important, and we have to take that current issue, and then others will surely support here. A report came in that a peasant had been maltreated in a nearby village. Gandhi decided to go and see. The next morning, he started out on the back of an elephant, and he started that journey. He had not proceeded far when the police superintendent messenger overtook him and ordered him to return. So here, police superintendent's message, and the messenger was there. He had given the message. What is the message? For the order, order him to return to town in his carriage. So here, there was an order from that police superintendent. And because of that, here we can understand. Now, just to proceed to that problem, he would investigate the problem. But we can understand. Suppose he would go there, then he will get the information. Other pigeons will also support him. So most of the time, such type of leaders, they are being prevented to go there and investigate. Then Gandhi complied. The messenger drove Gandhi home, where he served him with an official notice to quit Champaran immediately. So notice was given to quit that Champaran immediately. Don't stay there. That is the order. Gandhi signed a receipt for the notice and wrote on it that he would disobey the order. So now Gandhiji said with legal way that I would disobey the order. And what would be the consequence of that disobedience? That he will be arrested, or he has to present in the court. So, as a lawyer, what would be the consequences? Here, Gandhiji can understand, and with the help of that, here, we can understand what would happen next in this phase. So, up till this, today, we will stop here. We will conclude up till this. Whatever the things mentioned in earlier videos, make notes properly, read that lesson carefully, think in positive way, and jot down all the points. The points will help you for the final exam.